Melissa Torres says she chased the man in her own car while she was on the phone with 911.
And she wouldn't let herself cry because she was focused on helping cops find the man who took her daughter. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez joins us with more.
Well, Doug and Shelley, the view from Sky 7, you saw APD search for the suspect for both the air and on the ground. Melissa Torres says some kids playing outside saw the abduction and immediately ran over to tell her. She grabbed her keys, her phone, and took off to find him.
I was scared, angry, everything.
Sky 7 flew over the chaotic scene Wednesday evening as APD searched the southeast neighborhood around Catherine and Ortiz looking for David Hernandez. Melissa Torres chased him across town.
Focusing that my daughter's in that car with this man, who knows what he could be doing to her in that car right now.
Police say Hernandez led Torres on a high-speed chase on I-40, weaving in and out of traffic. He jumped onto I-25 South and raced through busy surface streets towards the fairgrounds in the southeast.
She told me that he grabbed her by her arms, her wrist, threw her in the car and told her to stay there and to be quiet because the baby's sleeping.
Torres says she didn't ram his car but accidentally ran into it when she lost control.
I could have crashed into him, but for the safety, knowing that if my daughter was in there, I didn't want to injure her.
But her daughter wasn't in the car. Police say Hernandez pushed her out moments after he grabbed her when neighbors started yelling at him. He ran away and disappeared until he turned himself into police today.
Mr. Hernandez, did you shove that little girl inside your car?
No, I did not.
She watched Action 7 News cover his arrest and shook her head in disgust at him. She says her little girl saw his picture and told her that's the man.
What's that like to feel that you almost lost him?
Scary. Scary. I don't ever want to lose my kids.
Torres is a young mother of three. She says her daughter wasn't physically hurt, but she's watching her closely and monitoring her behavior.
Torres also credits the teens who saw the abduction and immediately ran to tell her. Action 7 News anchor Royal Day was there when Hernandez was booked into jail, grilling him with questions on whether he had anything to do with the kidnapping.
Mr. Hernandez, did you shove that little girl inside your car?
No, I did not.
You told Rio Rancho police today that this was all a misunderstanding. You want to clear it up. What's the misunderstanding?
I'm innocent.
You're innocent? There were a lot of witnesses there who ID'd your car. They ID'd your face from your driver's license. What do you have to say about that? How was that a misunderstanding?
I have no, I just wanted to speak to a lawyer.
So you say you're innocent right now?
Yes.
Hernandez is charged with kidnapping and child abuse.
Rio Rancho police tell us they picked up David Hernandez at his construction job after he called 911 when he saw his picture on TV. When we looked into his criminal history, court records showed a plea deal in 2008 when Hernandez was accused of leading deputies on a high-speed chase to the East Mountains. Hernandez has no history of kidnapping or sexual abuse in New Mexico. Parents in the area, of course, are furious tonight. They're just learning there was another kidnapping last week. And even worse, the little girl in that case was sexually assaulted. Target 7's Lauren Zakalik digs for answers as to why APD never alerted the public.
Two little girls in just 1 week kidnapped, police say, from the same exact spot in northwest Albuquerque.
Who knows what he could have did with these kids? What if nobody ever saw their kids again?
Those emotional words coming from the mother of the first victim, a six-year-old girl. She was allegedly kidnapped last week right outside her grandma's apartment near 12th and Indian School, then sexually assaulted.
I was like, oh my God, they didn't even catch this guy.
Her daughter escaped and told police everything. So why didn't APD pass along those frightening details to the people living in this community? Well, APD tells me it's because they didn't feel they had enough concrete evidence to put together a proper alert. Family friends say the most recent kidnapping could have been prevented with just a little bit of vigilance and information that a child predator was on the loose.
Nothing was done. And look at, you know, he thought he got away with it, so here he comes back and tries to pull the same thing, and that's not right.
No, it's not.
I was mad, I'm fuming.
Police can't yet say if the two incidents are related, but if they aren't, the connections are chilling. The little victims are even friends. For Target 7 in the North Valley, I'm Lauren Zakalik.
APD says it will do DNA testing on the suspect to see if he matches DNA taken from last week's incident. And depend on Action 7 News for continuing coverage on this story. Hernandez is expected to make his first court appearance tomorrow, and we will be there. Then stay tuned to Action 7 News live at 5, 6, and 10 for the latest developments.